Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an IC693MDL240. This is described as a 16-point 120-volt AC input module. So it's a discrete input, 8 A channels, 8 B channels, and it's 120 volts AC. To tell you a little bit about the test procedure, first I just want to show you what I have set up here according to the wiring diagram. I have my neutral connection from a 120 volt AC wire connected to terminal number 19 as described here. And I have my hot lead or load 1 connected to a probe. So when I'm ready to do the test, I'm going to plug this in and I'll be able to touch all the corresponding points, terminals 1 through 15 in order to initiate all these inputs. Okay, so the physical configuration that's in front of you right now is an IC693CHS397 5 slot rack, IC693PWR330 power supply, and the processor is an IC693CPU374+. Alright, so in Proficy Machine Edition, what I'm going to do is open a new blank file. I'm going to select the CHS397 5 slot rack, PWR330 power supply, CPU374 plus CPU, and the MDL240 that we're going to be testing. So the same configuration I'm putting in my navigator bar under main rack is the same physical configuration that you see here in front of you. Okay. But once that's done, I'm going to click the lightning bolt icon in the upper left hand corner, which is the toggle online offline button. And once that's connected to the CPU, I'm going to click on the handprint, which is toggle to online mode, or put it into programmer mode. And once I've done that, before I go any further, what I want to do is take a look at my slot number 2. You can either double click on slot number 2 where the MDL240 resides, or you can right click on it and select configuration. We want to see under values and parameters on the settings tab where the reference address is. In this particular file, for my purpose, mine is going to be %I00081. For your reference, it may start with just 00001. But just make sure that you know where your reference address is, so that you know where to look for the inputs being turned on and turned off as you probe them. Okay, so the next step is I'm going to go to Target, top of your screen, and go to Online Commands. Another screen will pop open. You want to go to Clear. And when you get the clear memory screen up, you just want to make the bottom two selections, which is clear fault controller fault table and I/O fault table. You don't want to clear any memory in the CPU that you may want to keep or is important to you. So again, just the controller fault table and I/O fault table. Select OK. And then the next thing, of course, is select Download and Run, which is the button that looks like downloading information with a green arrow going down and a play button in the same button. And you're going to get a screen that pops up that says Build in Progress, and it'll ask you what exactly do you want to download to the controller. So for our sake, for this test, we just want the top two selections, which is hardware configuration and motion and logic. So we don't want to write anything to permanent flash memory or any initial force values. This will be sufficient for our test. Select OK. And of course, after this build is complete, it's going to ask you if you want to start the controller. Enable the outputs to yes or OK. Now it's in run mode. So what we could do at this point is go to your navigator bar, open up your default tables or expand your default tables, which is under reference view tables, and double click on input or right click and open your input table. And then you need to go to the corresponding bit, which are now only zeros, but they'll turn to one as you turn them on. and find out where yours begins. I have to start at 81, so I have to find out where that location is first. Then once I have found it, I'm going to go ahead and try and turn all these bits on by touching each terminal point with the corresponding channel. So I'm on A1 right now. For user reference, you could see that the LED under A1 is on, and as I go through, you'll continue to see these LEDs go on. However, just because the LED is coming on doesn't necessarily mean that the information of this input is being sent through the CPU to your program. So just make sure that you are able to see it on your reference view table as you go through and test all these. Again, these LEDs, these numeral LEDs that come on, they are good for user reference, but you know, they don't mean that everything is working perfectly. Okay, so I was able to see all of the, in the input view table, I was able to see all the address locations turning on and off as I was probing each one. So that's exactly what you want to see. It's a very simple module. It's on or off. Couple common problems that we see is either the light comes on when you probe it and you don't get any information to your reference table, or when you touch it, you don't get a light on at all. Those are pretty much the only two problems that you're going to see with this module. It's a pretty simple module. It's a module that we commonly repair here at PDF Supply. We also offer exchange program, new and remanufactured products, and same day shipping. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.